Hello, everybody. My name is Link7, and oh man, Breath of the Wild never disappoints. About 3 months ago, I uploaded a video of a brand new glitch that was just discovered, which allowed you to infinitely dupe hearts and stamina vessels, which allowed you to basically get full stamina and full hearts at the same time. And now, 3 months later, a huge sequence break and glitch has been discovered in Breath of the Wild, which allows you to literally jump like if you had a moon jump cheat code activated in the game at all times. You can basically infinitely jump in any area, so you can gain infinite amounts of height, reach areas you're not supposed to, skip puzzles and shrines, go out of bounds, and a bunch of other really cool stuff, such as flying up on the ground. So you might be wondering, how do you actually do this glitch? Well, I'm happy to say that this glitch is actually fairly easy to perform. So any of you guys out there can definitely try this out for yourself, and you should be able to nail this within the first few minutes of trying it. But without further ado, let's get right into the tutorial of how to do this. So first off, there is a few requirements to doing this glitch. The first thing, and the most important thing, is that you need to have a horse. If you do not have a horse, then you are basically screwed. So go ahead and get a horse. Then you also want to head to a specific part of the map. So if you look at the screen right now, you will see that there is this little stable right here. And if you go straight left of it, there's going to be the kind of this horse mini game where these two guys are sitting next to a tree. Now, this is where you want to go with your registered horse so that you have your horse and you have also 20 rupees to enter the mini game. At this point, I would also recommend you to save the game just in case something happens, because there is a chance, if you fail it in specific ways, that the game could softlock, but I've only had that happen once when I was actually testing the glitch to like push its boundaries, and if you do the actual glitches correctly, then you should never have any problem. But either way, after getting to this minigame, you want to go up and you want to talk to this NPC. And you're basically going to say, no, I don't need to buy anything. Yes, I would like to spend 20 rupees to enter this minigame. After you enter this minigame, there are a few properties of this minigame. So you're supposed to go around and shoot a bunch of balloons during 1 minute. And after that, you automatically get taken out. Now, immediately when this minigame starts, you want to turn around with Epona and actually right up on top of these cliffs. Now, it's very important to note that if you ever land on the ground in this minigame, it automatically ends the minigame. And the actual point of doing like this minigame and how this glitch works is we basically need to be on another horse as the minigame ends. So what you want to do is you kind of want to ride around here, and then when the 10 second mark is about to hit, you then go to the ledge, you jump off, you paraglide to the horse, and you want to land on it. Now, the horse is actually trying to kick you off of it, and this is why you want to wait to around a 10 second mark. If you actually tame this horse, then the glitch won't actually work, because it's just going to spawn you back on Epona or whichever horse you have. So you want to make sure you don't tame the horse, so you only want to be on this horse for a maximum of maybe 2-3 seconds. So that you're just literally sitting on it as the timer runs out. After that, you're going to notice that you're like, it's a really glitched mode where your horse is constantly moving backwards as basically the text is up. Now, this is the only really part you could fail on this glitch, and that is if you let this stay for a while. If you let this stay for a while so that the horse goes really far away, the game is going to try and load two areas at once, and it's not going to work. So all you want to do is you basically just want to go through the two text boxes, press no to select that you don't want to play the minigame anymore, and you're then just going to spawn on the horse in this kind of a glitchy state. And you can see that Link is actually trying to stand on the horse and he's glitching back and forth. And at this point, you can obviously mess around if you would like to by taking out the paraglider or trying to hit him with your weapon. However, there's nothing actually purpose of that. All you need to do after this point when you're kind of glitched onto the horse is press the minus button so you can take up the map. And then you want to warp to one out of any locations on the map. It doesn't matter which location, just warp to any location on the map. And after warping at this point, the glitch is now active. So what you will notice is that if you start pressing the jump button over and over again, you can just infinitely continue to jump over and over and over again. Now, there are some other strange behaviors that I'd like to mention that is very important to know when you're playing around with this glitch. If you use magnesis or stasis or any objects like that, or if you, for example, enter a climbing animation or just do specific animations in general, sometimes you will notice that you lose the ability to run. You're just gonna walk really slowly. If that happens, how you actually get rid of that so you're able to play the game normal again is very simple. All you have to do is just warp to a location. Because if you warp to any location, then you're immediately going to lose that effect and you're able to play again. So if you happen to have that, then just warp to another location. Now, you might also have seen the beginning clip of the actual video here that I used the paraglider and I was kind of shield surfing up mountains. And you might be wondering how you do that. Now, you might be noticing that if you try this glitch out yourself, the game always thinks that you're standing on the ground, so you can't really easily just do a jump and shield surf. So, how you actually activate this is by standing on the ground and having Revali's Gale unlocked. If you use Revali's Gale, and then you basically take out your shield and then take out your paraglider, you will then start getting in this kind of a surfing animation. And that's when you can kind of just surf up. Now, one thing to note as well is that you can actually get stuck when you're doing this glitch if either you run out of stamina or is at certain locations or maybe in a specific part of the animation it tries to climb a wall. And then, like, if Link is absolutely stuck, the only way to get out of that is basically by equipping one of the two bombs and then double tapping the L button. And by doing so, you will then bounce off and you're going to be completely free. And at that point, you can kind of just roam around freely. Now, there are a bunch of other really cool kind of tricks and glitches you can perform with this. People are testing this right now. A few questions that I've already seen that I guess in speedrunning related news, if you're more interested in that, you might want to know. People have asked if you can escape the Great Plateau early. Now, one thing to note is that this lasts through loading zones. So you can activate this glitch, go back into the main menu, and start a brand new file and start the game with this glitch active. Now, if you do that, it doesn't matter. You cannot escape the Great Plateau, so the Great Plateau is not going to be able to be skipped. Also, are you able to enter specific Divine and Beast early? We haven't found a way to do that yet, but I'll keep you guys updated on that in the future. And also, another question is, well, if the actual glitch stays through loading zones and save files, then how do you get rid of this glitch? Well, it's actually pretty simple. All you have to do is you just have to mount your horse. If you mount your horse so that you're basically riding on a horse, the glitch gets automatically canceled. So you will also notice because of that effect, because it always thinks that you're actually on top of a horse, that you cannot spawn your motorcycle on your save file. And if you do have it spawned, if you jump on top of it because you mounted it, it will cancel the glitch. Because that's basically how it works. It basically is in a glitch state to where you have control over Link while he's mounted on a horse. So because of that is the only way to actually cancel out of this glitch. Now, I was testing this for about 1 hour yesterday, just doing different kind of mechanics on my stream. So I'll put a couple of clips up of some cool side effects I've been able to find with this glitch specifically. And if you guys find anything really cool or interesting, be sure to let me know in the comment section down below because I'd love to make a follow-up video to this, updating everyone on some crazy new discoveries or skips that are able to be achieved with this glitch in mind. So I'll leave you guys with a couple of clips. Thank you guys so much for watching the video, and I will see y'all in the next one. Dude. It re-triggers the fight? Dude. Nice. You can pull out the shield. Yeah, let's scroll down the follower list to someone that has a bit less viewers. Wait. Wait. Wait.
The Rook's protection is now ready to roll.
Alright, let's try this shrine, chat. Let's see how difficult this shrine is. Alright. Dude, hold on. Let's try and enter hero mode, or master mode. Yes, the only time you're forced to horse is the final boss. It cancels the glitch then. Alright, play in master mode. Yep. Yep. Still works. Holy dude, this glitch is very powerful.